Hi, everyone, and welcome to Quilt Talk Tuesday. My name is Tina Dillard with Quilting Affection Designs. We are today talking about the Rainbow Serenade Quilt Along. We're on week four. And with week four, we're going to discuss unit four on pages 10 through 12. This one's a little bit more complicated, but it's a little easier at the same time. You just got to be careful of what you're concentrate on what part of the blocks units we're making. So let's get started. But first, if you have any questions at any time, please go ahead and put them in the comment section. Even if after the video, if you put a comment in the section there, I will answer it for you because I will get a notification on that. So let's begin. So with unit four, we are you need to make some half square triangles that will measure 4 inches finished. So you're going to make 4.5 inch half square triangles. You're going to, by using the colors in step one, and you're going to make some three different types of colored half square triangles, and you're going to press them, and then you're going to trim them to 4.5. So that gets you started for step one. So with the next step, step two, you're going to cut your some 3.25 inch squares. You're going to, for all the colors that are listed in the chart. You'll want to make sure you follow along on that chart so you'll get the correct numbers. And then you're going to take those and you're going to cut them diagonally once, and you'll end up with 2 of each of the colors listed. So once you get that done, you're ready to move on to working with setting up your corners. So with that, I have gone ahead and I have cut our first corner here. So you're going to line it up and you're going to cut 2 inches away from your half square triangle unit. And I'm using the one that is demonstrated in the pattern. So if you want to follow along, you can do that. So you'll take 2 inches off using your corner pop tool, which I've already done this, but you'll want to remove the 2 inches. And then you're going to replace that with the color that is listed in your pattern. So our first corner is going to be replaced with a wine triangle. So you're going to lay that wine triangle on top, flip everything over, and you're going to line it up, and you're going to go ahead and sew. So let's go ahead and do that. You're just using your quarter inch seam allowance, making sure everything stays lined up and your seam lays down as you sew over it. And now that's done, we are going to remove that piece and we have a triangle that's oversized. What we're going to do now is we're going to press. Now, you're going to press away from the half square triangle unit. So let's go ahead and do that. I have a little iron here. I'm going to go ahead and do that real quick. And we are done. So Now we are ready to go ahead and square this off. Like we have finished off, cut away our the excess mount. We're going to use our 2-inch line on our corner pop tool. Line that up. You're going to do this for every corner. And make sure you line up all the way around. And you're going to go ahead and trim. So there's our first cut, our first corner. We have a nice clean corner. So now I'm going to lift this up. And now we're going to, so you'll notice that it looks like what's in the pattern. So we have that in the corner. So now we need to remove the one of the other corners, and that's going to be where the blue is. Now you're going to follow your chart on your pattern just like so. You're going to, this is your first cuts, and these are your bottom cuts. So this side we're going to remove the blue, and we're going to replace it with the aqua color here, the azure. The next one will be a fuchsia color and followed up with a grape color. So that's how that runs on the pattern. So we are going to remove this corner right here. So we're going to take 2 inches away. You're going to line up your ruler. Now I'm doing this for a left-handed person. It's going to be the opposite corner for a right-handed. So I'm going to remove that. I'm going to remove that piece. Now we're going to sew on our next piece. And we're going to line it up again, making sure that the replacement triangle lays on the bottom. I found that the easiest way to make sure everything lines up correctly. And we are going to go ahead and then we can sew that across. And again, you're just using a good 1/4 inch seam allowance, making sure everything lines up. If you have to, you can pin. But we're just going to sew a good 1/4 inch seam allowance. And we are going to press this open again. So we have two colors in there now. This one we are going to replace underneath. We're going to press towards the half square triangle unit instead of away. So that was what we're going to be doing next. Now your pattern will show a little bit different. I have put up a replacement page for that. It is in the pattern corrections. I'll make sure there is a link for that on our pattern page in the description of this video. Once this we get through the next week, I am going to be sending out new patterns to the people that have purchased them already. I have a list, and I will be contacting you through via email. If you purchased it for a pattern that needs to be mailed, I will be mailing it to you. But I want to make sure that the pattern is correct and you get a nice replacement pattern that you should have paid for, but I'm sorry that we found all these errors in the pressing. These are just going to be corrections that are going to help you fix, make sure your pattern goes together nicely for the next time or in future uses. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to remove the 2 inches again, lining up everything first. And we are going to show you the next cut. That's the next one. So next, we are going to remove from the red side. So we're going to rotate our fabric around, and we're going to find our 2-inch, and we're going to remove that color. And we're going to replace that with the fuchsia. And you're, like I said, you're just repeating this over and over again. It does go a little bit faster. You just got to concentrate and make sure you lay out your first half square triangle correctly. So we're going to replace it with our fuchsia color. Flip it over. And I'm going to flip it over and line up. And we're going to go ahead and sew our 1/4 inch. So now we are going to cut these threads off, and we're going to open this one up. So now we're going to press away from our block. So let me go ahead and do that. And like I said, this is gonna, it's just repeating the process over and over again. And you're just gonna rotate it around, and you're gonna find your 2-inch on your your corner trim down. And you're going to line it all up again. And it does take a little bit of time to make sure everything lines up. Line it up best as you can. And let's go ahead and we're gonna trim this edge. You're just going up and across to remove the pieces. So we have one final image, the corner, to remove, and we're going to replace that with the grape now. So let's go ahead and remove the 2-inch. We're just going to line it up with our corner pop tool, and we are going to remove it. And that piece did not remove. That's fine. I can remove that. Now, we are going to flip this over, and we are now going to line it up again. We're going to make sure everything lines up, and we are going to sew our seam allowance here, good 1/4 inch, like we have been. And we are now complete. So all we have to do is just press this one open and press away from the center, like we have been. So, with that done, let's go ahead and trim. And then we'll talk about going ahead and laying out all of our units, since we are now complete and we have done our units, all of our units for this quilt along. We'll be discussing them in this week, and we'll be discussing them in 2 weeks in November also. Okay, so this is what your units will look like. These are the first units, so you'll see those, what those look like. And here are our second ones and some more of our units and what they look like when they are complete. Now remember, when you do the azure color, you're always going to press towards the half square triangle. This is going to help with the nesting of the block, as this is going to be the center of the block, so you'll want that to help with the nesting. So we have done that. Let's show you the last couple, and that's what they look like, the center of these all your blocks. So now let me show you what your blocks will look like. Just one second. I need to grab my blocks that I have pre-made. I forgot to grab them this morning. And I have made our first block. So what you're going to do is you're just going to lay out all of your units. You should have them organized and ready to go. And all you have to do is lay them out. Like so, and you're just gonna line them up, and then you're gonna sew your units together. So if you wanna go ahead and do that, the first couple of blocks, you're only gonna be making two of each of the blocks. Go ahead and do that. This is my center. So what you'll see is everything is gonna line up in a color rows. So, anyway, you're going to also make sure when you're laying these out that the block is always facing outwards. So when you remember to do that, you'll have all the blocks laying outwards on your square. So when we put them together, you'll see that they are going to work together. You're going to find some of the nesting is not particularly friendly because the way this block is put together. So if you have to kind of move things around, play with the block as you put it together. So something to be aware of is some of the nesting may not be there. I've corrected a lot of the nesting already just doing this pattern. So we are ready to sew our blocks. So go ahead and do block one and block two, I've already done also. So you'll see that they can go together. So in a couple of weeks, we will, starting November 6th, we'll be back for week 5 of our Rainbow Serenade Quilt Along. Hi, Sally. Hi, Kim. And we're going to finish it up, and answer any other questions on this quilt block. I'm going to be looking through some of my patterns, and maybe we can find another quilt along we can do here shortly. I think these are very informative for everybody, and I think it'd be fun to do for another one. So I think that is it. Really don't have any questions. Thank you all for joining me today. And remember, if you miss an episode, you can follow me. It'll be on my YouTube channel tomorrow morning. And I'll be also discussing this all in a blog post on Thursday. You can find all the links in the description area. So thank you for joining me today, and I will see you on November 6th at 2:30 p.m. Thank you and goodbye.